I'm in New York, just got here, met this sister, and immediately she said what?
I'm a fan of yours. My God, I can't believe I just saw you right now. when I make it to Dakar, I'm definitely going to contact you guys,
wife. Yeah. Right here in Harlem, y'all heard it first. What's your name?
Ayana.
Ayana, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
This is Sun here?
Yeah.
What's going on, brother? How you doing?
Good.
What's your name?
Ahmed.
Mashallah, that's my little brother's name.
Aww.
Ahmed. Mashallah. All right, we'll see you guys in Senegal soon, okay? All right, y'all take it easy.
Take care.
It's a pleasure. Mashallah. Getting ready for the Most Influential People of African Descent Awards ceremony. I had to come over to my old corner. I used to live in that building. Fifth and sixth floor was my apartment in 2008, 2009. Right here on the corner of Lenox and 115th Street. As most folks know, in Senegal, you know, a lot of the Senegalese people here in New York, they live right here on 116th Street. So it was always my community, living around the Wolof people, the Senegalese, the Senegambian people. But yeah, so a little bit of history, man. That's my old apartment right there behind me. Right there, those four windows and the sixth floor. Had to come pay homage, all right? Showing love out here in New York City. The award ceremony's this weekend. I'm right here at the United Nations headquarters building in East Manhattan, getting ready to enter the Africa Open for Business conference, led by Jibril Jallo of Arden, Senegal's own. So we're going to be talking about development. We're going to be talking about putting the pieces together to create the sustainable, you know, environment and atmosphere that that Africa needs. So it starts here, all right? United Nations, Most Influential People of African Descent. I'll be being honored here in about 48 hours at the end of this weekend. And so we'll take you along for some of that. But stay tuned. Just wanted to bring you guys some of the views here at the United Nations, all right? Peace. It's Exodus time. UN headquarters. Got a lot of movers and shakers here. My sister Khadija from Sierra Leone. Yeah, Africa's in the building. We're well represented at the UN. Here. United Nations, we're at the event for Arden, Jibril Jallo, great dude, a lot of movers and shakers here, a lot of great progressive personalities. We're having a good time linking up, networking, creating some opportunities together. So stay tuned, we're going to bring you more from the United Nations General Assembly.
Ambassador Chahnya, permanent representative of Senegal to the United Nations. As you know, Senegal is the current chair of the African Union. Ambassador Chahnya, in spite of his busy schedule, worked tirelessly to make sure that we convene at the headquarters of the United Nations in this time of the 77th session of the United Nations General Assembly. So I'd like to extend a warm thank you and a warm welcome to Ambassador Chahnya. Thank you very much. Made history, this is the first time that the Vice President of Colombia is addressing an audience inside the United Nations headquarters.
It's framed and everything. So, congratulations.
And we will travel to Colombia, to Bogota, to officially present you. Appreciate every effort that you're making. really in the great nation of South Africa, among the people of South Africa, promoting the Red Card campaign. So we want to again recognize that you are our guest of honor during Africa Day in this very hall, Queen Magatsi, and we're very proud of you, and we thank you very much.
Yes, Queen.
Now we will open the floor for introduction.
This one is saying, the ancestors are pleased with you, our son, because violence against women has been throughout the time of history. And when we see the red card, it represents the male child into our language. Thank you, Mama, for whatever you are doing. And those who are here, I mean the men, support this man who is there for us day and night. With whatever you have, I'm doing everything which I will make sure that even that 1,000 which we are looking for, with my team at home, the chiefs who are there to lead with me, we have got those. Please, Papa, may God, our loving God, give you more days so that you will fight for our rights.
Uh-huh. We have participants in the African Summit, Africa Open for Business, individually and collectively, in the room and virtually, recommitting themselves to doing everything possible to make sure that we use the convening powers of sports and culture to end all forms of discrimination and violence against women and girls. May God help us.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. The session is closed. Amen.
Over here with Queen Mother Blakely.
The Queen
Mother Blakely, always at the UN and all over Africa, being an ambassador for African people and indigenous people of the world. Of course, you know, you got Olima.
The royal family.
The royal family at the UN.
Thank you so much, Queen. Thank you. So what's going on? We're here at the at One United Nations Plaza, just outside the United Nations headquarters building, where the Mipad Week is kicking off. All right, most influential people of African descent. We're gonna be doing some photo shoots and stuff today. I know CNN is doing a panel, so we're gonna be tapping in with that. Talking a little bit about business entrepreneurship, which is what I'm being honored for at the MyPad event. So you guys stick around. I'm gonna just try and bring y'all some of these views, man. New York, we're here, all right? Came all the way across the ocean just to make sure that, you know, we represented, all right? Most influential people of African descent, all right? It's Exodus time.
Outfits, jump out styling, ladies smiling, paparazzi's everywhere. Hummer stretches, limo Lexus, pull up while people stopping, stare.
The whole thing looks like we're all on TV.
Ooh, sometimes life can be like a dream when you're living on a big screen. Fancy cars, movie stars, red carpet and big applause.
Out here right now, the Mipad recognition week. Got my family with me, Ali.
What's going on,
Senegal, based in New York, and we having some soul food. We have Red Rooster in Harlem. I've never been here before. Last time I was in Harlem, this place didn't exist. Beautiful layout that they got going on right here. So let's just kind of show the table a little bit. This is how we eat.
Food is even amazing. They can't taste that.
So you know, a bunch of creators, a bunch of movers and shakers, a bunch of impactful influencers, you know, here networking, collaborating. We're gonna be doing business after this, so you know, this is just the beginning.
We're eating like a steak.
This is how we grow, right? It's Exodus time.
It really is.
We say Exodus time. It's not just that everybody should just leave, but more so that we should exodus from the systems that we've become accustomed to, you know, right?
What they prize.
Right. We still send our kids to the public schools that are run by them, right? We still use a lot of the resources, right?
Right, so we say
it's like we got to separate from those things and build our own infrastructure.
Self-determination.
We have our own
free the land. Unlearn and relearn, right?
Unlearn and relearn.
Our own institutions.
If you get to the point where that calls for you to leave from here, then, you know, that's just like, that's a level. But it's not necessary for everybody. We just got to, you know, detach a little bit and build our own.
Congratulations to my brother, RJ Mahdi. UN has named him top 100 most influential leaders in the world. Congratulations. I'm glad to be a part of the world. Made in Africa Project, baby. Make sure y'all come. Repatriations, reparations, Senegal, Gambia, Ghana, South Africa. Come home. It's Exodus time.
I'll come in December too.
That has influence in this world, that makes a positive impact, and that cares about our community at large.
Thank you.
Stay.
Zappy.
Yeah, that's very good. Senegal and other individuals like yourself, Mipads, a recognition of the type of work you do and the declaration of the UN and recognizing African people's contributions.
I think it's right on time. The United Nations recognition this decade of people of African descent has been an extremely information-driven, an extremely communicative period for many African people around the world. We look at what happened in 2019, the year of return to Ghana. We look at countries like Sierra Leone now offering express citizenship and ancestry We look at the movement of African people from around the world towards the continent as a home base, as a place to embrace their heritage. And so now Mipad, tuning it all up by showing those people who've been most influential in that process is much appreciated. It's something that has been needing to happen, seeing as how our people have been the influencers and movers and shakers of every period of time that we've been around. But our story just wasn't told. We weren't getting recognition. We weren't having platforms that display our great activities and behavior. So I really appreciate Mipad for, you know, putting all of this together and, you know, letting us soak up the influence from our brothers and sisters throughout this recognition week.
Here is a video message from former High Commissioner Michelle Bachelet.
As Camille was saying, the mayor of whom we are so proud. Camille, come and introduce the mayor before we go on, please. Mayor Eric Adams, thank you for joining us tonight. It is always a pleasure. Before starting anything, I think that we owe a great debt of gratitude to Camille here present, please. My name is Jibril Diallo. I was recruited at age 27 by the late Kofi Annan as for the United Nations. And after 38 years at the United Nations, I'm working now for an organization called the African Renaissance and Diaspora Network, whose main task is to have a special initiative to breathe life into what is the diaspora. The African Union has declared what the diaspora is, but Mr. Mayor, we need to breathe life into that to make it concrete. Your visit to Africa, your visit to other parts of the world are doing that. So the African Renaissance and Diaspora Network is doing.
Everybody wants to talk to the mayor. Oh, wow.
Yeah, he must.
There goes the mayor.
Here. All right, so just a quick few announcements.
All right. Good evening. Greetings to everybody. Congratulations to all honorees. What does it mean to be a Mipad and to me? It means to be solutions oriented. Not only did I see the amount of misconceptions that we have about the African continent, but I saw an enormous amount of possibilities, an enormous amount of potential. And that was as a teenager. So I returned 12 years later with my career and some resources and my family, and I chose to be a solutions-oriented person. Where we saw deficits, we sought out to solve those issues. Whether in agriculture, whether in transportation, in infrastructure, in real estate development, in exporting local products, whatever it was, if we saw there was a deficit, we took on that challenge to make sure that we made an impact. And so for that, I understand why it's so important for us to get together in these types of events and environments so that we can all connect our ideas, so that we can share with each other what challenges we face in our parts of the world, and so that we can connect with those who have resources to solve them. In the past 2 or 3 days, I've been able to meet people here who literally answer the questions of problems that I see every day on the continent. And so I understand that going forward, if we continue to connect like this, if we continue to put our minds together, if we continue to let the cream of the crop rise to the top, there will be no more problems. We will have our solutions.
Headquarters for the most influential people of African descent. I got my man David Castain with me, and we're just sitting here chopping it up, and I just wanted to bring y'all what we were talking about. And the topic of discussion was not letting your image, dictate who people perceive you to be. I know a lot of us, we're from an urban environments. We're from the inner cities. We're from, the urban culture, and we like to dress a certain way. Don't be ashamed to dress how our culture likes to dress, because you can still be great, no matter what. People was walking up to my man, asking him, is he a rapper? Is he a singer? Is he entertainment? No, my man is actually about to pull a PhD right now in marketing. My man is doing Fortune 500 business around the world marketing. So don't just look at him because he got the chains and the hair and think that, maybe he up to no good. He's selling drugs. He's a rap. No, my man is actually out here doing big global business. All right. So I just wanted to give you that prop.
I appreciate
doing
it.
Huge things. Keep it up.
I'm trying to be like you out here.
Mashallah. Hey, it's Exodus time, man.
I'm on the leg. I'm here.
One of our co-founders in the cable line development.
What was your first trip to Africa? When and where?
My first trip to Africa was in 2001. End of the year, just after 9/11, so it was a particularly unfavorable time to travel, but I traveled and I actually lived in Senegal for one full year. During that time, I was able to study under one of the most prolific sheikhs of our generation, and so that 1 year experience is what I was prepared for, what to expect, and it's worked in our favor since we've been in Senegal.
I want you to talk about your first went to the continent. Yeah, like your first experience.
Are now moving to the continent. What is your thoughts about when this first migration started to happen? What do you think when you were hearing a lot about it?
It's about time.
Exactly.
We've been waiting for a time like this for a long time. 100 years ago, Marcus Garvey made the first major attempt. And so it comes full circle. We see people doing it. We really think about the improvement from what was happening back then. Like, what stopped us back then? Right? What made Marcus Garvey fail? Right? Why did it get cut short? Right? Liberia. right? Mm-hmm. We tried that.
Yeah.
What made that, you know, fall off its rocker? Mm-hmm. And so we learned from those things. But now what we see is not only a greater flow of people coming back to the continent, mm-hmm. but also a wider range of destinations, mm-hmm. right? You know, we've got pockets of repatriates landed now in Tanzania, Uganda, Kenya, we've got communities in Sierra Leone, Borneo folks, Mali, Ghana, Gambia, right? So we've diversified. We've spread ourselves out so we're not overwhelming to any government or space. And so again.
So 15 years ago, I used to bus tables in this restaurant, okay? This is Les Ambassades, Senegalese restaurant in Harlem. 15 years ago, I used to work behind this same counter. I used to serve these same tables. This was my first time living in New York, and this is how I made a living, like, straight up. Tonight, this weekend, I'm being honored by the United Nations Most Influential People of African Descent, and we celebrate eating here in the same restaurant, Les Ambassades, right here in Harlem. So, full circle, just wanted to, you know, put that out there. We all, it's family either way, right? It's Exodus time.
My man,